Well, hello everyone, and welcome yourselves back on into New Cycle. I hope you're all well. Now, I've done a little bit just whilst you're away, so I've added in a couple more wind turbines just to get a little bit more power without the use of people. And we've got 3,000 and something from here as well, and I've just been out scouting. There's only been a couple of days past in-game, just sending the scout out. I'm kind of just making sure everything was in order before I started, so I wasn't fumbling about. But our scout's on their way over to the last one of this forest here, so it'd be ideal to get maybe meet here, but I just want to show you how efficient on the world map it actually is to grab these. So we've got 8 workforce here, but look how much we're bringing in. So that's more than 3 log people at mine, and the same for the meat as well, so it's pretty good. And we haven't even got the food supply yet, or tool supply, fuel supply, all that stuff, so we're doing pretty good. And I think we can boost the logs even further later on when we start to work on that as well, so that's really good. And we're doing the same at the other province. Now, it does cost us people, obviously, but we're getting there. And what we're going to do straight away is go into the enhanced hands-on training. So for a lot of the mining now, we need to make sure we're getting people in to do that. And that's costing us all the paper. But that's fine. We've got plenty of people running in the paper at the moment. So we've got 5 there, 3 there, and 5 there. I think what I am going to do, this one's still good. We're actually producing enough from the one here. So I can actually keep that one going. And I'm just gradually trying to train. I probably should stop doing it until that research is done, though, to be honest. And I've built one more house. But everything else is good. Now, one of the things I want to do is go into the tier 2 production here. And I want to try out, I need to get both the kitchen and the distillery. But I want to get the kitchen first to see if these filling meals do anything better for people. We've got the bricks for it. So I want to go ahead and probably get this one in first. And I'm thinking, housing-wise, I'm probably going to go this way just to get into that, and then maybe a second one over here. I know we've got the stone deposits and stuff, so I think, would it make sense to go there? We might end up putting a house there. I think this bit here is fine. Let's get our first kitchen in there. And we're obviously producing wires and stuff again now, so everything's looking good. And I've gone ahead and taken the glass off here because we're not using or producing it at the moment for upkeep, and I've changed to tin up here just to get a nice surplus going of that. We've got 95 on the tin, so that's going to come in pretty handy. And then once this construction's done, see, that was 12 glass. We can obviously use that in here anyway, so I've just been going through it, and anything I can just tick for when it's needed in here anyway. We can see how much we've got in stock just along here. Kind of the best way to look at the stats, I think. So if you go into production tab, so it's this overview graph, production tab, and then table instead of graph view. I find the table view a little bit easier to look at, and you can tick any and it'll add it onto this row. And we've ramped up clothing now as well, so not necessarily workers, but I'm trying to get a surplus in case we get hit by anything before we kind of move into this stuff. Oh, and just one more thing on the overview. If I go into the grain here, we actually are the surplus of grain is getting pretty good, so I think I'm going to put that over here. Storage-wise, I've built another storehouse as well, but I think this one being closer to the farms might make sense to have the grain inside of here. There it is. So I might increase that to maybe 1,500 there as well. All right, training complete. Fail. I'm not going to hit any more until we go into the next thing here. And we're going to see what the regulation is here. Leave the Stone Age behind. Chief, we propose a new arrangement. We don't have to meet our clothing needs with leather rags anymore. From now on, we wish to wear more comfortable clothes by using a mixture of leather and linen in our clothes. But we're not producing any linen yet. People will understand, but they won't be happy. New form, new regulation, weaving, average per capita clothing distribution of working class decreased. Chances of disease from weather condition decreased. We kind of need to take it. It's going to give us a new thing here, right? But, yeah, it's a bit of a problem. Because we've now got to produce some linen. So what we'll do then is just flip this to linen. Get the last one in there. What we're going to have to do, this is going to cost us water, but water's looking fab at the moment anyway. And I think what I'm going to do, herbs wise, I'm going to go like this. We're going to max that one out. And why is our power needs now a bit naff? I haven't built anything. Oh, we built out on the world map, didn't we? Okay, let me see where I can change someone down here. I think I can take one out of you. Pop you in there. Oh, there we go. Oh yeah, on the world map. Group of travelers, this is perfect. Okay, so what I'm going to do for this last bit of summer then is I'm quickly going to go through. We're going to get everyone in gathering on these with the spare people. So no resources there. I'm going to get some more meat there. Leather. I'm going to get one more in there. I'm going to get another one in there. That one's almost gone anyway. That one's got two in. That one's... I'm going to knock that down to one then. And what I'm going to do... Oh, we've just lost something there. Going to go ahead and get one more in bricks. And then the rest... I think I want to do some training once this finishes. So we're going to get... We're going to start with two. Because it costs us tool every time. And we are going to clear debris and get one straight back in. They're not very good over here, are they? Did I get a better position for this? You really don't get a lot from them, do you? No. There's actually a decent little patch over here that we could get some more wind power if we wanted to. So we could build out another wind farm over there, but we need to save a bit of space. But there we have it. That research completed. Now, what do we have next? Production chains and advanced techniques. We're going to go into production chains because that's the general workshop that we're going to need. Let's check in on our kitchen now. So what does this do? Meat, veg, mushroom, water, grain, vegetables, 6 per 1 hour. Oh, which one's going to be best here? I think I might do Alakaito. We're not using grain for anything else, actually. Vegetables, quite a lot, though. There's a lot of vegetables in this. Maybe a more meat-based one. A lot of water, though. That one doesn't use any water. Let's go with this one. We've got plenty of it, maybe. And let's get two in there producing some of those. Now, I'm not sure what we need them for just yet, but we've got a barter here as well. This is going to come in handy. So, to be fair, I'm pretty good on most things. Might not hurt to grab in some bronze ingots here, although yeah, we could. We have a lot of meat to kind of counterbalance this with, I guess. There we go. We'll take bronze ingots off you. That's all we're going to need off you, because we're kind of just turned off the production of that whilst we do tin, because we don't have the workers for it. So yeah, we've got one off at the moment, and this one has just got the one in producing tin. We're kind of flipping between tin and bronze ingots at the moment over here. All right, with that new population as well, we're going to need to get in another resident building, and I need it to be in line with this pub. So, we're going to go there. I think that reaches just fine in there. Now, medicine-wise, to be fair, this should probably go in here, and then we move some more houses so I can cover up this little row for housing as well if we're being the most efficient here. Perfect maintenance. Nice. That looks good. All right, are we getting our stuff in now? So, clothing now. Let me just check in. Health-wise, their clothing distribution rate and stuff should be good here. So we have the ability to turn down the workforce to cheer them up a bit as well, but they're both relatively healthy at the moment. We can obviously increase that. The only thing we need is medication. I think I need to turn on lavish meals up here as well, and I don't think bricks necessarily need to be up here. Bare meal, sorry. I don't know. You click it left. Well, does it tell me if people are actually eating it? I have no idea. Ah, here we go. So you can change them from simple meal to fair meal. Very, very good. Okay, so what I might do here then to boost this, I might say fair meal for the craftsmen, because they are giving us power at the moment. All right, let's speed it up. Let's make sure our scout is still going. They are. So inside of this valley, we can also build certain things. So we've got the watchtower we've got off at the moment. We could also get the roads in. We just need some more bricks, which we'll get. That's diesel engines. I don't think this valley's worth it at the moment. We did grab one on the shoreline as well. I think I'm going to get both of those built on the shoreline here and the roads. Let's get all of that done. And then I'll get some workers in there where I can. And let's go back in. Training complete. It looks like we did get one out of that, which is perfect. So I'm going to go ahead then and do this. Get you in there because you give us better. Not enough resources. So let's reduce those guys down. And for the remainder, we're going to need another farm then. So this is where the water usage gets kind of ramped up, doesn't it? So this is production, isn't it? So let's get another farm. I think... Is it because I'm using these sections a bit too much now? Yeah, over here is good, look. The best you can get is 4 or 5. So I think the other side of this is fine. And I'm just going to bring this road into here. Then that one we're going to get on the kale or something again as well. And I'm going to grab in, not kale, what am I on about? Wonder how many you get out of the kitchens for these. 520 power though. I think we need to stay with the smaller ones. I reckon your production's way better on these though. Yeah, look how much better the production is. We definitely need to consider another one of those then. Shoreline established as well. Very nice. So we're going to need workers out there as well. So we'll get those guys in ready for when these kind of come in. And we've got one more spare. And let's just check in and see how we're doing on the food front as well. So this one, you really do struggle with a lot of them because, well, meat is just fantastic at the moment. So we need to base our meat values around that, or food values around the meat. Yeah, that one's almost gone. I'm going to quickly pop them in there, clear that one out so I don't have to worry about it. And there's the general workshop as well. I'm going to just wait here a second. All right, we're going to slow that down. Bring those three out of there. You're good still. You're almost done. Resources are gone for you. You're good. Okay, I'm going to bring that down to one as well. And we are going to go ahead and get in the next buildings here. And this is going to take power. So we're going to need... Actually, I've got a better idea. Let's go ahead and let's go with a double craft here, a double train. And then in the meantime, we'll just pop one more in there. That gives us 600 power, and that means I can go into our next thing here. And I think I want the distillery. 148 bricks, though. We have 102, or the general workshops, power tools, tinned rations, supply machinery. That's going to give us better production outside. This is going to give us better production inside. So, which one's overall the cheapest? 86 ingots, 90, 30 bronze. I'm going to go ahead and say distillery, guys, and I think I'm going to pop it over here. I'm going to squeeze it right here, actually. There is two mineable resources there, though. Tell you what, let's go in this gap here, and we can squeeze roads around the back if we really want to. You know what? We're going there, and what I'm going to do is just pop a little road through here. Now, it's worth mentioning that there are some features that will be coming out in the new game. I've been speaking to them on Discord, the devs and the community guys are really, really good. So any feedback you kind of see or want to give as well, do pop it in the comments and I can relay that if there's anything that you want to change. There's multiple things I've already suggested. One of them being when I turn off something, I want... That's not even on. When I turn off something, I want the workers to come out of them automatically. That's like, those are the types of things I'm kind of looking for, you know. I'm going to keep that one there just because of the gatherer camp, but I don't think we'll be using it. Right, I think, yep, we're seeing some more children here as well, which is scary because that means our population's going to boom once again. So we are going to need more residences and I'm going to need to fit them in. I think what I'm going to do, just whilst we're here, guys, I'm going to go ahead and demolish that one for a start. I'll demolish these. We'll get some resources back, which is good. I know this isn't ideal right now, but I'm going to also go ahead and bin off that. And I'm going to say infirmary. Get rid of that. Utilities, infirmary. I think I'm going to go right there. Then we're going to get some more residences in. See, that fits quite nicely there now. And then I'm going to see what I can do with the roads here. I think I might just leave that one. So I can get one there. I think that will reach all down here as well. So I might just go straight into another one here. And that means we can get a pub here. And it keeps them inside of this as well, you see? So we want them inside of the guard towers, is my thinking as well. So we should be good. All right, scouts arrived as well. Meat makes us resilient. Yes, it does. Okay, so that's over here. What I'm going to do is send the scout down into the lowland here. And in the valley, or is that in the forest, sorry, I'm going to go ahead and, well, I'm going to go back in again. Let's try that again. This one here, I'm going to grab the hunter's cabin. That's going to be ideal. And then we need to get more workforce across. So we've got 14 over here. What have we got? So we did get a mine, didn't we? Wow, the mine can take 6 workers. What do we get? 32 coal will be produced per day. 36. That increases everything, right? Based on this. So what we need is to max this one out most likely to get the most out of this. If I just go like that. Then what I can do back at home is reduce the amount of coal that we're doing. Right, training wasn't very good. So let's get 2 more on the train. Yeah, so coal... I can actually take a worker out here, so we've got a really basic amount kind of going there. And then copper, I think we're producing more than we necessarily need there as well. So we're going to need to up our clay production a little bit here. That should level out because we did up our bricks here. So bricks are looking good. Food's also looking good. That's keeping our workers very happy, I think. That fair meal distribution. Food quality of 4. Need to get more. Okay, we've got 1,094 in now. So once this distillery comes in, I'm doing one thing at a time. I don't want to overdo it. That's the importance of what we're trying to achieve here. And I'm keeping a close eye on what we're cooking as well. So mushrooms, fish, meat, and leeks. All right, and then in this kitchen here, I didn't flip it back. I'm actually going to say use whatever's got the most. Go 6 per hour there for those guys as well. It's a shame you can't put one of these in there. But anyway, we have the distillery. And it looks like alcohol is 20 grains, 6 alcohol per 4 hours. So you can tell people to drink that, I guess. And in order to produce medicine, we need alcohol. Drink. So I'm going to go with medicine. No, we're going to need alcohol first. Oh, man. Right, we'll get one worker in there then. That'll produce 2 alcohol. And then maybe you. So 7. And we're going to need another one. So this is going to cost us an absolute fortune. But it fits nicely there. And another worker for it there afterwards as well. Perfect. That's going to take us over the power limit once that's in. That's 750 power. So to prep us ready, rather than using people out in here, I'm going to bring this up. And what I'm going to do is start another wind farm over here. So we're going to go windmill. I'm going to utilize this space quite heavily for wind, just to kind of balance us out here. I know it's not ideal, but it's going to help whilst we don't have the people, right? Worst cases, we can knock them down. And then we can fit in whatever we can over here as well. And I'm pretty sure they get quite good over here. And we'll go like that. Right, that'll have to do for now. And with those spare workers now, we can get them in elsewhere. So let's make sure everyone's good. Clothing is now still not where I want it. Right, we got 3 in each. Let's go one more, and that'll take us over the edge, right? All right, up next, we're going to need linen. So how much have we got? Yeah, it's linen that we're struggling with, isn't it? So actually then, I think our problem is more so that we're not producing enough linen. That'll give us 2 per day. I'm going to drop this down then, and let's see if we can get this up. And there's the scout in the lowland. Sorry about the music, by the way. The music just randomly stops in this version of the game, so not a lot I can do about that. This lowland looks like it could be pretty good, though. I'm going to go round like this. Oh, no, actually, let's go you first, then to you, then you, then you, and then you. Or to the seaside. I need to look at what we're doing here. So this forest, what are you producing for us? Good amounts of water. Okay, so what that does mean then for power, I was just thinking, there's some that we might not be pumping from. So I'm going to go ahead and flick through. So water here, not much resource in there. Okay, like that one. That one doesn't use any, so it's the big water pumps, isn't it? I know we've got some of those. Yeah, like this one. That's 260 power right there. You're still going. You're also not doing anything. These, we've got to remember, and I've asked for a way of being a bit more obvious with that. Residence buildings are looking good now as well. So hopefully we'll be able to continue working on this production chain when we've got the bricks in. Let's check on the research now. Only one left in this tier is going to be the advanced metalwork techniques. Boom. Okay, this is kind of scary, these things, right? Long distance communication. I kind of want this, though, because getting the fruit in would help massively. And there's the basic machinery. Oh, man, it is scary how much is actually here, right? Takes us into where... Was that only cycle 5? That was. Okay, cycle 6 is next, which we've got. That's like petrochemicals and things like that as well, isn't it? Okay, so let me just check in. You're doing herbs. This one isn't doing anything. Why? Efficiency minus for our winter. Okay, so we can take you guys out of there. The good news is the herbs still produce in the winter. And so do the farms. Good to know. Okay, in that case then, let's try and get a bit of a surplus of the linen. And then these shouldn't be running out. So if we... Yeah, okay, we're producing more linen than we are on this, and that means I'm going to need to get a third farm here. Need a good spot for this. I think there anywhere else that is good for farming. Okay, over here. Also good. But all this is pretty green, so I might start a little farm. Oh my god, look at this. Best you're going to get here. Oh, I found a really good spot there. What was that? Right there, look at that. Boom. I'm going to get a kale. Not kale. Grain farm in here. Healthcare. Research opportunity. Chief, our knowledge of chemistry and aromatic plants has advanced immensely. We may have become the only community capable of producing drugs in the past half century. With a little support and a bold mindset, we can take ourselves even further. We believe vaccine production, one of the standard practices of the old world, won't strain us too much. Okay, but some will agree with you. Vaccine, I think it's important that we do these. Right, 65 bronze ingots, 240 herbs, 150 alcohol. Yep, this is going to use our stuff up, which is a bit annoying, but we've got everything other than that, right? Hold on, that's different than what I said. Glass, copper, bronze. What? I'm confused. Okay, well, you know what that means then. We're going to need to turn on... Have a look here. Let's get you in there. Take you out of there. And we're going to need to get you in there. We need a couple more in there, right? Clay's not looking good. Why has that taken a massive hit then? Let's knock the bricks down a little bit then. Let's pump up the glass right now. We don't have enough workforce. Why? Is it because it's been turned off for a little bit, isn't it? Yeah, okay. So what we'll do then is flip that over. We'll flip you over. And we'll let that kind of do its thing. We'll get some glass ready for this. I didn't quite realize. We'll just produce that one then. And there's the end of year. The replenish of 66%. That's not the worst in the world. And message from the scout. Okay, mineral deposit. Let's see what we get. Perfect. Right, where are you? Let's go back to this one. This valley we also need to get. We're doing good over here. There's still more that we need to build. So we need these kind of to grow up. We've got 17 children. So we're going to be able to fill up the world map really, really soon. And we are not utilizing all of our workers properly. So if we go you and you. So I think we can sacrifice two for one of those, right? So it kind of is kind of good in that way. Let's get one more in there. So we're producing a bit more coal. Although... yeah, that's good. That's perfect. That plus the world map should be good. And then I'm going to go back out onto the world map. I'm going to go into the highlands and I'm going to give one more over here. That should tick all of this up to what we need. And then when we grow up, I'm going to fill this one up before we move into the next one because I need two more in there as well. All right, so we're waiting on the last lot of bricks in there. That's where our clay and bricks were going. Clay looks good again now. Yeah, that was weird. You're producing 7, you're producing 11, and we've got a little bit of glass. I'm just keeping an eye on the sand over here, because we're still pumping out a bit of stone. It might even be worth getting another pit in. What I can always do is flip between the two of these, though. I can just get a quick pump of sand up here. Might even take that down to 5 now. And because we've got all our food stuff in again, look at this. Look at all that meat. Our coal is now full also. We need to make sure we've got a storage for this. Upgrade main hall. I will do that in a moment. What I'm going to do is say a bunch of coal on there. Because there's no harm in grabbing that in. Time to erase the traces of our days of weakness, fragility, and fear of tomorrow. Let us upgrade our main hall structure, which served as our first roof when we made this place our home. Okay, an important day. Upgrade main hall. Ooh, this is exciting. This is going to cost us a lot, though. We got... iron. Yeah, there's the glass. Okay, we'll get through that though. Develop theoretical training center as well. I need to look at that one. Just looking at this, the pub, what? This has a huge range, but what is the purpose of the pub? Is it just a better version of this? Hold on. I think it might be, you know. There's me moving everything around. Okay. Right, I think that is the pub. Right, I won't upgrade that until we've got everything in then. Don't want to do too much at once. Got 515 meals here. We're producing a lot more than we're consuming. So it's tempting to get another one of these. We've got plenty of power based on efficiency here. So I'm going to say no more of you. We've had a couple of people die, but that's fine. Let's go ahead and get another one in the bricks. Sorry, I know I'm cycling through a lot of different stuff. I'm just making sure we've got everything we want kind of here, you know. You're good. You're good. You can also start producing some more leeks again. You can produce some more herbs. And then you are going to do grain. And the rest of my workers are going to bring the grain in for alcohol. I reckon I can get rid of that. And we're going to put grain here. And there it is. Okay, so you're good. Yeah, gotcha. So this one is going to be that building. Yep. Right, I'm going to reduce the wire production as well, so there's not much we need for that at the moment. I'm just going to keep two in there. Tools look good. What are we struggling with here? Maintenance is brick. We're on full maintenance. I'm going to drop that down to medium. And tools, I think, are absolutely fine still. And we have a fire. Full response. Go, go, go. Then over here, this one's going to be our first medicine. And I'm going to put in two workforce there. Not going to produce much. Tin ingots. We've got tin ingots, right? We've got loads of tin. I know what my problem was, by the way, before when I said there's a bug with it and I just destroyed it and got rid of it. It's actually when you've got it turned off for a while. It has reduced productivity for 5 days. There it is. We'll get that one repaired then. Got everything for that. Fire does cause an issue on efficiency, unfortunately. How's clothing? So clothing is way better than where it was. So I can actually reduce that now. They've got the linen. So that's more workers again. Look at all that paper. Right, let's actually start to use some then. Let's start with horticulture here. And then clay also needs to be bumped up because we're producing too much. So let me take a look. Let's take a couple of you out. Sand, absolutely fine. Let's knock you down a little bit and let's get these, yeah, let's go back to this. Let's make sure we've got everyone in, grabbing some mushrooms here. We've got loads, but we may as well get them in because I'm going to build a second kitchen and utilize more meat. Two in there. I think I've got the gist of what you need to kind of do. I'm going to leave those two there. You're good. All right, let's check in on the water pumps as well. Although, yeah, we're consuming a lot more than we're producing. So this one has the ability to turn on now. Just going to go back to it. Let's go to the other ones. That one's also off. Let's get the 120 a day from that as well. And scout. Feel a little bit more relaxed. We've got a little bit to do though. This is good. Glass will be gone from there. That one's filled out. Last bit of bricks going in there as well. So the main hall's going to be upgraded. Not even sure what that means for us. Go this way. Let's go across to here. We've got three spare, haven't we? So let's go ahead and make sure we're getting them in. Let's max out that region. That gives us a good amount of coal. So I'm actually probably going to turn off the mine over this way. And then that is also very, very good. So logs, we're officially in a surplus without having to worry too much. Which is very nice. And obviously 21 children here. I'm hoping to flip this over, keep the simple meals going, just ticking over, and then flip these guys across. I need to train a few more workers as well. That's only with two in there we're producing this much. The only thing I'm noticing is vegetable usage. I might need to change the recipe here. We've got no grain either though, so fish, vegetable, and water. That one's probably our best bet anyway for the amount it uses. But what we just need to do is make sure that we are producing a fair bunch. This. Go ahead and max that out. And then green. I think I can go ahead and probably reduce the mushroom guys down, actually. Let's get another one in there. And then we've got alcohol. Tin still not showing, though, which is... we need a working class here. Hey, there we go. Perfect. A group of travelers. Wow, nine. That's not good. What I'm going to do is four. I'm going to go for four-man train here. And we still got 1,400 on the power, loads of people. So we're going to go one more in here. What are you doing? You're still pumping. Good. One more in the leeks and another one in the veggies here. We're good on linen. So something's going on with these. Have we got too much in? I think we have. Right, I'm just going to check in on the linen here. I feel like my stores don't have enough. So 480. Yes. Okay. So this store here needs more linen then. We have so much meat. Look at this. We need to flip more of the other ones to meat. All right. Linen there. There's our problem. Let's go up to 2,000 on that. That should start producing a bit better again. Don't think we need this many though. So let's reduce that down. And let's actually now just seen our wood here from the amount of building we're doing. I'm going to flip that one over. I'm going to reduce the paper down because we're actually in a good place here. And we're going to just look. Mushrooms and water. That's fine. Fish. Did remove those. I think they're still ticking over nicely. Meat, and then right, we're going to change this one to meat. That's less water consumption, less meat consumption. Yes, we're looking great. All right, so what do we want next? Well, we can go to the metalworks and start providing that, or we can get the general workshop. And I think we need the general workshop. All right, I think housing-wise, we seem to be pretty okay, but I really want to upgrade this tavern. We need 34 bricks in order to do that. How are we looking? Glass, bricks. Boom, let's go up again. And let's just check in. They're looking pretty healthy. We just need access to medications. So this one here should... Quote me on it. Need those workers, right? They're almost there. We should get one out of the four here. There's development of orchard, though, as well. Load distribution, basic machinery, theoretical training. That's what we need, basic machinery. So let's just grab basic machinery. Let's slow it down and let's get... But we won't slow it down. Come on. Train me, train me. Oh no, that is so unlucky. Right, we're going to go four again. A lot of workers spare. And let's go ahead and get in. Whilst we're waiting then. Or we could do the orchard. Don't think we want the fruit just yet. Still waiting for the bricks as well. Kind of want to upgrade this first. I'll tell you what, let's hit the upgrade so all the bricks go into there then. That shouldn't take long. There we go. Bricks are already in there. Lovely stuff. Get that upgraded to the pub. And that is true. So the tavern turns into a pub on upgrade. Rather than placing a new one. Way better range. And then we'll obviously upgrade that one to a hospital when we can as well. From an infirmary. I'm going to go ahead and grab one more storehouse in as well. And I'm going to pop that over here. Go nicely there. And this, because of the where we've got the farms here, I am going to ramp those up for those guys as well. Looking good on mushrooms. Meat is just insane right now. Water's looking good. I think I'm just going to pump up all the other numbers over here that we do have here. And I think I'll go out onto the world map. And let's actually utilize the roads where we can. So I think you... need your workforce. That's supplying a good amount of water. Let's go ahead and get in the bricks. All right, as we don't have the bricks to do anything out here, I'm going to go back onto the map here. But I just want to point out, main hall has been completed and my training did complete and we got three more workers out of it. So I've actually put in them into here. So, well, I don't know if that's working just yet. Yep, there we go. So we are officially producing, even though that says it's red on that. I'll just slow it down. And the main quest also to upgrade the main hall did finish. So we're going to click OK on that one. And boom, here we go. Oh man, I didn't even realize we were going to get the new main hall. This is going to be good. But good attractiveness and good... So I guess attractiveness gets you more people in, I've noticed actually. And also the pub did upgrade. So I just want to point that one out. There it is. Look at the range on this thing. Actually, we're good for housing. There we go. It does cost us more paper, though, as well. So we do need to make sure we're grabbing that one in. I'll just wait for the main hall to finish. I'm just going to flip over and just make sure everyone is good here. I need to check in on the fish situation. Everything else is good. No, we're still good on fish. So I'm just going to up the fair meals as well, because actually we're going to be able to go into that one. Power tools has been completed, so theoretical training is the vocational. We could also get this one and go supply. What is the conveyor belt system? Multiply our working. All right, I think I'm going to go with that one because I want to get into some of the conveyor belt systems because one thing I've been really excited about. Look at this, though. Look at our main hall now. Oh, man, this game's gorgeous, isn't it? As far as post-apocalyptic go, it just looks so good. Guys, I think that's the perfect place to end this one out. So as always, please do smash the thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. And if you want to support me that little bit extra, do consider becoming a member of either Patreon or of the channel. As always, guys, hope you have a great day. See you in the next one.